Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Team Manjaly, and I will be speaking about the problems of using alternative medicines, namely Ayurveda and homeopathy. So first of all, before I go into the topic, there is a common argument that I face when I talk about such commonly used medicines, that is like anecdotes. We hear a lot of stories about how your great-great-grandma used this medicine that cured her illness for that has been persisting for such 10 years or so, or some like, you know, dhyanakendrathi poittu achandalege vechippa like 10 varshayilla thalavena mari. You know, we hear a lot of stories like that. So first of all, I'd like to give you an example or instance of such a story and the problem with such stories and how it's not reliable evidence. So the problem is that my neighbor, okay, they have a dog, and they always say that whenever this dog is howling like a wolf or something, that the death is approaching, that somebody in the neighborhood is going to die soon or something, okay. So the first time I heard about it, what happened was like someone actually died and this dog was howling. So I was actually like curious about this. But next few times, like the dog like kept howling like next few times and nobody died. The fact was that nobody remember these instances when the dog howled and nobody died. They only remember that one time when somebody died and this dog was howling. So it was just a coincidence. So what happens is like essentially anecdotal evidence adds up to nothing more than a coincidence. So then I'll start first with the Ayurveda. So Ayurveda is a traditional Indian medicine system which is based on balancing of three forces or fluids, Vata, Pitta and Kapha, which is said to be composed of the five elements, that is not the ones in the periodic table, the other five, sky, earth, water, all those five elements. And the thing about these elements, these three forces are that nobody has ever been able to detect these forces or quantify it or measure it in any way. So what essentially happens, it's more or less sounds like magic. So what happens, they claim to treat or cure an illness by balancing these forces that nobody can see or detect. And another thing about these Ayurvedic medicines is that we don't know what they actually contain. I mean, we all know what plants they are composed of, what plant parts they are using for the specific medicines, but we don't know what these plants contain, what the actual composition of these plants are. Like we can even go so far as to analyze the composition of these plants, but the composition of a plant, they vary with seasonal nature or from area to area. So we can never know the composition, and there's like huge risk associated with eating something that we don't know what the composition is of. It can trigger some allergies or some other conditions, and there's no way to know what caused these problems. So that's the problem with Ayurveda. Another commonly used form of medicine is homeopathy. The problem with homeopathy is that there is almost no drug content. If you actually look into the principle of homeopathy, it is not much different from magic. The idea behind the basic principle of homeopathy is that a substance that causes a disease in a huge amount, a huge quantity, cures that same disease when used in a small quantity, which essentially translates to saying curing a snake bite by using a venom of the same snake in a small quantity. That's what the basic principle of this homeopathy is. And what they do is, and one of the processes involved in creating, I mean, while making these drugs, like homeopathy drug, is like beating this drug, okay, this drug sample against a leather bound book. Now I have no idea what effect that has on the drug, but it sounds a lot like magic. So it doesn't always work. And as with most other remedies, we all hear the same anecdotes. So another thing about this homeopathy is that it doesn't like have any drug content. They dilute this drug so much that nobody can even detect this amount. What we are essentially consuming as a homeopathic remedy almost always turns out to be nothing but placebo sugar pills. So what I just want to say is that before we try any other homeopathic or any other forms of alternative medicine, it's better always to rely on allopathic medicine, which is evidence-based. We all know that it will work. It has been tested, tried in clinical trials, and it undergoes many stages of testing before they are approved for human use. And therefore, we can safely use them, and it will work. Most probably, it's more likely to work than the other remedies. So, with that, I conclude. Thank you very much.